I lost the dragon and keep this hand. It seems quite good. This is elves. It's elves. Alright. I think getting out the Eidolon sooner rather than later is probably. Okay, never mind. May have mislabeled this guy. Alrighty. Darn, he already has 3 mana for his lord here. I think I'm dead. You can now do a huge call of calling and just destroy me here. Ah, oh, my opponent's so talkative. Let's just get this game over with. I'm gonna ignore him for now. Slowly pick off his creatures. First his druid, or his lord here. That's it actually, I don't care about the other creatures. I can see him, I'm just fetching. Whatever's in his hand, I'm hoping it's a land. Okay, here it comes. The big elf lord's overrun ability costs 5 mana. So he needs to tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can't actually do anything. Means I can just kill off his creature end of turn. I can do it now with Helix. Oh, what a waste. But yeah, that's what I have to do. He can now tap out save his creature. But now let's kill it next turn with the ping. Either way, I gain 3 life. Catch? Yep. Oh yeah, that works. Coco? I'm hoping for a miss here, or something irrelevant. Another Coco. Oh, he can grab back his lord. Not a bad play. And here he can Coco again by fetching the land. I might actually lose here. Oh my god, a druid? That'd be really bad. Oh, but he fetches his land, he loses the druid. I see, that's interesting. So now I have ammunition to kill his droid. Really need some mana now. Cocoa time. His buying back Cocoa play was pretty brutal. Yeah, that's okay. Another nam nam. Okay, that's not too bad. Sure. He'll swing for 4 and I'll just kill his droid. Or he can swing for all and I'll just block this and then kill his droid. This is getting really frustrating. Perhaps I should have played the Lord the Eidolon a little bit earlier. So I can't swing until I kill off his Nam Nam somehow. Freaking death touch. I can't double block it without losing both my creatures, so it's just not worth it. Baldur, it's fine, doesn't actually do anything. GG. Fairly long and grinding game, but I finally got there. Yeah. He had a bunch of small creeps, but no payoff. Searing Blaze is good here. Path is good here. Command's decent here. Not good, not bad. Pulse Board, you should have things like Kitchen Finxes and Eidolons. Scavenging Oozes, making Eidolon a lot worse. I'm not a huge fan of creatures this matchup, but I think leaving them back to block is fine. Here we go. It's not the greatest hand in the world. I do like Lightning Bolt though. Whoa, no plays turn one. That's pretty good for me. First. Yep. That's some card advantage for him. He's gonna path me? I'm kinda funny if he does. Nah, I don't think so. Alright, so I don't need to swing at him for actually I almost can kill him now. Just need two more burn spells. As long as he can't gain life, I have it. Alright, I have Leaf in hand. Can I kill him in 3 turns? Okay, let's think about this properly. I go Helix in a turn, then I can go Rift Bolt plus another Helix. Next turn. And then I can finish him off, yeah, okay. I can have this done by turn 10-5. Well, for me, it'll be 10-4. Well, he can actually kill me next turn. Pretty darn low, yeah? Of course, if he goes Coco and gains life, I'm just gonna be in a lot of trouble. I should've swung. That was just stupid. He wouldn't have blocked that turn. So not swinging may have cost me the game there. If you can gain life, of course. If you can't gain life, that's still winning anyway. You still play Coco here. But only one Coco though. Wait, how's he tapping his card? Oh, a big spell or something. What is this? Oh. Okay, it doesn't have haste, so it's fine. I think I'll just block his Druid. There's a chance that my greedy play, because I didn't actually have to play this greedy. May have cost me this game. In comes the Rift Bolt. So it does have Coco then. I was hoping he didn't. Yeah, PJ.